Last, I will unmute to all of you. We have to study about the female reproductive system. As we have studied that, what are the female reproductive system and what are the different parts of reproductive system of females. Now we have to draw the diagrams. With the help of diagram, we can understand very easily about the female reproductive system. So please open your book and see the figures that is given in your book. We have to study about female reproductive system. We have studied about different parts of the female reproductive system. Today we will draw the figure of female reproductive system. With the help of figure, we can understand very easily. So first of all, how can we draw the female reproductive part? First of all, draw a line. Means you have to draw triangle type structure. Is tarah ka structure aap bana lo, which will help you to draw. After then, there should be a curved line type of structure from upside. Here, there should be an outline diagram. We have to draw in such a way. This is the easiest step by which we can draw it very well. Then this type of line should be drawn. We have to draw, and then there should be common passes from this portion. After then, what we have to do, we have to erase this line. We have to erase this line, and zigzag line should be drawn. Such type of line should be drawn. This is the easy way to draw the figure. We have to draw it in such a way. After then, there should be a tube like structure which we have to draw. There should be a tube like structure which we have to draw from both sides. In such a way, we have to draw the figure. After then, when we will see the figure, then here is finger-like outgrowth. There is finger-like outgrowth found in fallopian tube. Such type of structure will found in both sides. That finger-like structure which is found in fallopian tubes are called as fimbriae. These are called as fimbriae. And here there is presence of bag like structure. That bag like structure is called as ovary, which is also paired. There is bag like structure. This bag like structure is also found in both sides. That bag like structure is called as ovary in such a way. It is connected. Now the figure is complete. We have to label the complete figure. If you will see about the figure, there is different type of structure, and this structure is female reproductive organ in which there are the different parts. We have to label the diagram. This is the fallopian tube. cube, or it is also called as oviduct. It is also called as oviduct in fallopian tube. There are many parts about which we have studied. These are the finger-like outgrowth, which is called as fimbri. This is ovary. This is ovary. This is the uterus. This is the uterus. If you see the structure of all these organs, then inside this inside structure is called as endometrium. It is not given in your book. This is the endometrium. This is endometrium. This portion is called as cervix. This is called as cervix, and this portion is called as vagina. Vagina. Now we have to see the role of female reproductive system in reproduction. What is, we have studied about the male reproductive system, in which we have studied about the role of different parts of male reproductive system, like testes, vas deferens, vas efferens, seminal vesicles, prostate glands, Cowper's gland. We have studied about the function of all the reproductive parts of male reproductive organ. Same way, we have to study about the role of different female reproductive organs in reproduction. If we'll see about the structure, then this portion is called as uterus, and this round structure, which is two in number, this is called as ovary. This is the primary sex organs, which is found in case of the females, and that ovary are paired structure, which is found in both sides. And this ovary is helpful to release the ova, as well as it is also important to release the different types of hormone like estrogen and progesterone. We have studied about the estrogen and progesterone, that estrogen is helpful to develop the secondary sexual characteristics in female, whereas the progesterone is also helpful to hold the pregnancy in a proper way. Due to insufficient secretion of progesterone, there is miscarriage in the females, due to which this progesterone is very helpful to carry the pregnancy in a proper way. Then what happens? From this ovary, there are the ovas. There are immature ova which is found in the ovary. When a girl child born, we have studied, when a girl child born, at that time there are many immature ova are present, more than thousands. Many thousands ova are present in the female girl baby. And when it starts to reach in puberty stage, at that time the number of ova are become reduced. It going to reduce day by day. Then what happens? After puberty stage, after starting of the menstrual life in case of females, there is the releasing of ova. There is releasing of one ovum from each ovary in an alternate way. In alternate way, there is releasing of ova from each ovary in alternate way. If there is releasing of ova from this ovary, then in next month there will be releasing of ova from this ovary. In alternate way, there is releasing of one ova from each ovary. And when ova or ovum released from ovary, it reaches to the fallopian tubes. In fallopian tubes, there are finger-like structure. That finger-like structure, it is seen here. There is the finger-like structure. This finger-like structure is called as fimbri. And the function of this fimbri is to hold, to catch the ovum very easily, which is released from the ovary.
In that situation, when the ovum is cast by the fimbri in fallopian, which is present in the fallopian tube, it start to carry. This ovum start to goes into the fallopian tube where the fertilization occurs in the female reproductive body. When the ovum released from the ovary and cast by the fimbri of the fallopian tubes, it goes into the fallopian tube. There are many parts of the fallopian tube that is called as one. We have studied about the fimbri. There is the infundibulum. After that, there will be the swallow part in the fallopian tube. That swallow part is called as ampulla. It is called as ampulla. This part is not given in your book, but there should be knowledge of ampulla. This is the place. This ampulla is the swollen part of the fallopian tubes where the ovum fertilized with the sperm. Means we can say in a very simple way, we can say that fertilization occurs in the fallopian tubes of reproductive parts of female reproductive organ. Fertilization occurs in the fallopian tubes of the vagina, because when ovum reaches here, sperms also reach at that place. How sperm reaches at that place? If you all have studied about the male reproductive organ, that there is the releasing of sperm, and during copulation, what happens? That sperm is stored in the vaginal tract, inside the vaginal tract of the female, and from there, if you'll see the number of sperm released in one ejaculation is near about 200 to 300 million. There are 200 to 300 millions sperm are released in one ejaculation. In that situation, what will happen when the sperms are stored in the vaginal tracts of the female? Most of the sperms are killed by the secretion of different type of chemicals in the female reproductive organ. Only very few numbers of sperms are remain, and when these sperm reaches into the fallopian tubes through the uterine wall, in that situation what will happen? It start to fuse with the female gametes. It start to fuse with the ovum which is present into the fallopian tubes. And when the male gamete, means sperm, fuse with the female gamete ovum, in that situation there is the process of formation of zygote, and this formation of zygote by the mixing of male and female gamete is called as fertilization, which I have studied in previous classes. There is the process of fertilization in which the male gamete, means sperm, fuses with the female gamete ovum, and there is the formation of zygote. There is the formation of zygote. After then, what happens? That zygote start to divide rapidly. There is the mitotic division in the zygote, due to which it start to divide into two cell structure. After then, there is four cell structure. There is eight cell structure, 16 cell structure. You all are familiar with the mitotic division, in which there is the formation of two daughter cell from one mother cell. So after formation of zygote, when the zygote has formed, then what happens? There is the formation of zygote inside the fallopian tube, because here there is the presence of ova in the ampulla region. In the ampulla region, there is the presence of eggs. And when sperm reaches there, there is the fertilization, due to which there is the formation of zygote. After then, there is the formation of cleavage. There is the division. There is the mitotic division in the zygote, due to which there is the formation of marula. It is not given in your book, but you should have the knowledge. There is the formation of marula, means a stage which occurs after the mitotic division in the zygote. There is a marula stage, and from after marula, there is the blastocyst stage. Note down the word. Marula, blastocyst. Let us see once more. What happens when there is fertilization in the fallopian tube, where there is the fertilization in fallopian tubes in the female reproductive organ, you can say that the place where the fertilization occur in the fallopian tube is called as ampulla. Ampulla is the swollen part of fallopian tube where there is the fertilization, where there is the mixing of male gametes with the female gametes, where there is the mixing of sperm with the ovum, and it result in the formation of zygote. As we have studied, it result in the formation of zygote. In that situation, that zygote start to develop. Suppose that what happened if there is the structure of zygote in such a way, let me draw in a proper way. Suppose that this is the formation of zygote, then there will be a division. After then, there will be formation of cleavage, two cell structure banenge. From two cell structure, there will be again division, four cell structure banenge, eight cell structure banenge, 16 cell structure banenge. That the first stage after the cleavage formation is the marula stage. There will the formation of marula. Suppose that these are the eggs which start to release from the ovary and cast by the fimbriae are reached into the fallopian tube. The releasing of ovum from the ovary is called as ovulation. Releasing of, once more, there is a releasing of eggs from the ovary of the females is called as ovulation, which occurs in a definite time period in the body of females. There is a proper time period, proper interval of time in one menstrual cycle of the female, and there is a releasing of ovum after the 14 days. There is releasing of ovum in 14 to 16 days, we can see, and then there is the fertilization. Suppose that what happens if there are the ovum present in fallopian tubes and sperm reaches from this portion. The sperm reaches through this portion. Suppose that this is the sperm where the head-like structure. You have studied about the structure of sperm. Suppose that these are the sperms. And we have studied that in one ejaculation, the number of sperms is near about 200 to 300 millions. But all these sperms are not survived inside the female reproductive body. Most of the sperms are killed by the secretion of different types of chemicals in the female reproductive organ, but few can survive in a proper way, and that sperms are reached into the fallopian tube. Suppose that yahan pahunche, then there is the fertilization where there is the formation of zygote. That zygote is start to develop by the mitotic division and start to come inside the uterus. Inside the uterus, this is the structure of uterus. If you'll see, then this entire capacity is called as uterine capacity. This is uterine cavity, and in this uterine cavity there is the lining. This lining is called as uterine wall. What happens when the zygote is developed into the marula? After then there is the development of blastocyst. When there is development of blastocyst, there is development of finger like structure in the blastocyst that is called as villi. There is development of finger like outgrowth, and that finger like outgrowth are called as villi, which help to hold with the uterine wall, which start to hold. Suppose that when it reaches into the uterus, which it come into the uterine cavity, here it attaches. Suppose that yahan par humne structure bana diya. This is marula. Marula, and when it reaches in the uterine wall, then there will be 16 cell structure. It attaches with the uterine wall with the help of finger-like outgrowth. That finger-like outgrowth are called as villi, which help in the fixation or implantation of the blastocyst with the uterine wall, which start to fit diet villi or finger-like outgrowth is helpful to fix the blastocyst with the uterine wall, or it is also helping the fixation or implantation of the blastocyst with the uterine wall. After then, what happens? Blastocyst has implanted with the uterine wall. Then what happens? The contact region where the blastocyst is come in the contact of this uterine wall. This contact region is start to grow to form a special structure. That special structure, which is the spongy structure or disc-like structure, is called as placenta. Is called as placenta. Note down this word. There is the development of placenta where there is attachment of blastocyst with the uterine wall, and that placenta is attached with the embryo, with the fetus. After then, what happens in placenta? The villi of the embryo come in the contact with the blood sinuses of the uterus, due to which what happens with the development of placenta in the uterus of the female reproductive organ, there is the proper nourishment of the fetus, which is present in the womb of mother. With the help of that placenta, there is proper nourishment of the fetus inside the mother's womb, means there is the supply of glucose, there is the supply of oxygen and other nutrients from the blood of mother to the fetus inside the womb of mother. Along with this, the waste product and carbon dioxide like materials are also excreted from the fetus into the bloods of in the blood of mother with the help of this placenta. So we can say that the placenta is helpful to nourish the infant, to nourish the fetus, to nourish the embryo inside the mother womb. Because it is very important question, sometimes it is asked to you that how the fetus is nourished inside the womb of mother. Then very simply you can say that the fetus is surrounded by a spongy disc-like structure which is attached to the uterine wall, which provide proper nourishment, and it is also helpful to excrete the waste product and carbon dioxide from fetus or embryo into the blood of mother. After then what happens? There is a proper time period of the pregnancy in the woman. There is a time period of the pregnancy in the woman that is near about 270 days. 270 days. This time period of 270 days is called as gestation period. Is called as gestation period. Let me write at a proper place. Here it is seen. The time period of 270 days called as gestation period. It is seen. It is called as gestation period. You can note it down. Gestation period. If anyone is asking that what is gestation period, then you can say the pregnancy period, the time period of the pregnancy in case of human beings. It is not for all the organisms. It is especially for the human beings. Different organisms have different time period of the pregnancy. This gestation period is different in different organisms. In case of human beings, the gestation period is about 270 days. But for the sake of convenience, we calculate that the gestation period is near about 40 weeks. this gestation period is near about 40 weeks, near about 280 days. For the sake of convenience, here there will be confusion that once I have written as 270 days, it is the time period of the pregnancy in case of human beings. But for the sake of convenience, which by which we can calculate very easily, that is the 40 weeks or 280 days. And this 280 days is calculated as the previous menstruation period in case of the females. In the previous menstruation period in case of females. So the actual time period of the pregnancy is 270 days, but 280 days is calculated because we calculate from the previous menstruation period of the females. And the giving birth of its young ones, the giving birth of a baby by a female is called as parturition, is called as, note down this word also, parturition. Parturition, this is also a very important word. Gestation period and parturition. Parturition means the act of giving birth of the baby by a female is called as parturition. Is called as parturition. I hope this topic should be very clear. Once more, I am going to revise that what happens when there is ovulation, means the releasing of ova. What happens, students? In one time, there is releasing of one ova in 1 month. And in alternate month, there is releasing of ovum from alternate ovary. If there is releasing of ovum, there is ovulation of one egg from this ovary, then in next month, there will be releasing of ovum from this ovary. Means at alternate month, there is releasing of ovum. And there is a time when these ovary stop to release the ovum. There is no ovulation of X or ovum after a particular time period. Means after that, we can say that the female will unable to reproduce its young ones. The female will be unable to reproduce its young ones. That period is called as menopausal stage. There are two stages. One stage is called as menarch stage, which is prior from the puberty, after the puberty. But after some time, when there is no ovulation from the ovary, that is called as menopausal stage, after which a female will not able to give birth of its young ones. So it should be known knowledge that what is menarch stage, what is menopausal stage, and how there is the fertilization. We have studied about the fertilization. We have discussed about the female reproductive organ. We have discussed about the fertilization, that how fertilization occur in the inside the female body. Now we have to discuss that what will happen when there will be no fertilization in the female body, in the female reproductive body. If there will be no reproduction, at that time when the egg will not fertilize, and the egg will not fertilize when there will be no fertilization, in that situation what will happen? Now we have to know. Once more we have to see the structure of this female reproductive organ. We have discussed that this is the uterus portion. Inside there is a lining. That lining is called as endometrium. This inner lining of the uterus is called as endometrium, and that endometrium is a highly vascular portion. And what happens when the egg is not fertilized in that situation? The egg will remain for one day. It can remain for only 24 hours. After that, it will degenerate. When the egg will remain and will discharged from the ovary and reaches into the fallopian tube, then it is remained for one day. After that, it will degenerate. It can remain for the 24 hours, we can say. Then what happens? This inner lining of the ovarian wall is called as endometrium, which is highly vascular. And uterus prepare itself for the fertilization to hold the fetus. In that situation, what will happen when there is no fertilization in the female reproductive organ? In that condition, if the egg is not fertilized, it lives for 1 day or 24 hours and then it expels. Then in that situation, what will happen? There is the motion. There is a motion that is called as the menstrual life or menstrual cycle in the female reproductive organ or ovarian cycle. It is also called as ovarian cycle, which occurs after a particular time period, means periodically, which occurs in the body of females. In that situation, what will happen? This menstrual cycle is a series of cycles which change that occur in the reproductive system in the female body after every 28 days. In that situation, the ovary prepare itself. The uterus prepare itself for receiving the fertilized egg. In that situation, there is a releasing of the lining of this endometrium, as we have studied. This lining has released, or we can say that this endometrium is very thick. It is highly vascular. It is elastic. And in absence of fertilization, this endometrium our lining start to break down. When there will be no fertilization, because this endometrium is helpful in the nourishing of the fetus inside the womb of mother. But when there is not fertilization, in that situation, what will happen? This lining has the breakdown, and then it slowly come down out of the female reproductive body in the form of blood and mucus. You can note down endometrium. Endometrium, which is highly vascular part, when there is no fertilization, then this lining has breakdown and come out of the female body through the vaginal portion in the form of blood and mucus. That thing is called as the menstruation, which occur at a particular time period in the body of female, in the reproductive system of the female's body. After then, what happens? At least near about 3 to abhi rehne dijiye. At least near about 3 to 5 days, there is the stoppage of menstruation in case of female after a particular time period. And when there is no menstruation in the female, that is called as menopausal stage. Menopausal period or menopausal period or it is also called as menopause, means this is the time when the female will unable to give birth of its young ones. Now only we have to study about the reproductive health, which we will discuss in next lecture. Now I'm going to unmute to all of you. If I have to ask anything, then you can clear your confusions. Yes, students, if there is any confusion, then you can ask. One by one, you can ask. You can clear your confusion.
Sir.
Yes, Ravi Shankar.
Sir, in how many days this endometrium again form?
After every 28 days, it begins to form. It starts to form in every 28 days.
Okay, sir.
प्लेसेंटा को ही अम्बिलिकल कॉर्ड भी कहते हैं.
व्हाट
सर? प्लेसेंटा इज आल्सो नोन एज अम्बिलिकल कॉर्ड.
अम्बिलिकल
कॉर्ड.
प्लेसेंटा इज अ स्ट्रक्चर इन व्हिच द इन्फेंट इज सेफ एंड गेट नॉरिशमेंट फ्रॉम द बॉडी ऑफ फ्रॉम द ब्लड ऑफ मदर. एनी मोर क्वेश्चन?
Marula
states, we have studied that when there is the formation of zygote after the fusion of male gamete with the female gamete, the zygote start to divide. There is the mitotic division in zygote, and a stage come after the cleavage formation that is called as Marula stage. When you will be in senior class, when you will be the student of class 12th, at that time you will study about the Marula stage. What happens when there is releasing of ova from the female body? Then it starts to carry through this portion, and where there is fertilization, where there is the fertilization, at that time during fertilization there is the formation of zygote. That zygote starts to develop that by the division. And during division, there is the formation of two celled structure. Then there is the four cell structure. Then 8 cell structure. Then 16 cell structure. Because every time from one cell, one mother cell, there is the formation of two daughter cells. So that structure is called as Marula stage. And after Marula stage, there is the blastocyst. That blastocyst will attach with the uterine wall. After 7-8 days after the fertilization. Okay.
Blastocyst क्या बोल रहे हैं?
Blastocyst बेटा यह stage है. जैसे ही zygote की formation हुई, zygote की formation के बाद उसमें division होगा. Division हो करके जो कई सारी stage आएंगी, उसमें एक stage है blastocyst, और उसी stage में finger like outgrowth develop करती हैं, और वह जाकर के uterine wall से connect हो जाती हैं. जैसे ही connect होगी, अब यहाँ पर प्लेसेंटा का डेवलपमेंट हो जाएगा. प्लेसेंटा इसको चारों तरफ से कवर कर लेगा. ठीक है
सर? ये ओविडक्ट फैलोपियन ट्यूब को ही?
व्हाट? हाँ, ओविडक्ट फैलोपियन ट्यूब को ही कहते हैं.
सर आप बोले ना कि एक समय सर एक ही रिलीज होता है. तो सर ट्विंस बेबी कैसे हो जाते हैं?
वहां पर डिवीजन होता है. बहुत आगे की बात तुम चली गई. You will study in class 12th in BSc that how there is the twin child in the womb of mother. There is the division of zygote. Zygote divide हो रहा है. वहीं पर जो blastula stage आ रही है, blastocyst stage आ रही है, उस stage में ही division होता है जो तुम class 12th वगैरह में पढ़ोगे. अभी तुम्हारे लिए नहीं है ये.
सर